Hello, I'm David Romo, and this is Lakefront News. We thank you for joining us. This week, Our Lady of the Lake is celebrating Founders Week, where the entire university community honors the founders of the institution of the Sisters of the Congregation of Divine Providence. For more information on events being held this week, contact the Division of Mission and Ministry at extension 2193. The South Texas Blood Bank Mobiles were recently on our campus to offer students a chance at donating their blood and informing donors on how the process works. Reporters Courtney Willie went to get the story.
The Volunteer Unity Council and the Office of Health Services sponsored a blood drive on campus. The South Texas Blood Bank Mobiles were located in the Moy Circle just outside the UAC.
It's important to get blood because it does actually save lives. There is a substantial need for blood, and you can imagine that the holiday season is coming up, and unfortunately sometimes there's tragic incidences where we need to utilize a lot of blood. The process can range anywhere from half an hour to an hour, depending on how loaded the bus is at the time. We'll be having two buses every day. The second bus will be here at noon, and I would allow 45 minutes minimum.
According to the South Texas Blood and Tissue Center, nationwide, a unit of blood is needed every 2 seconds, and almost everyone will need donated blood sometime in their lifetime.
I asked students on campus why they wanted to donate.
And it means a difference also for whoever, no matter what, if you're a child or in a military family.
Because it saves lives, and it's just like 1 hour of your time.
The mobile units are all over the city, and you can go to the South Texas Blood Bank's website, and they have a very convenient electronic make an appointment process. Or you can call them and go to the actual blood bank location and donate blood.
Anyone who is 16 years old, weighing 120 pounds, or at least 17, weighing 110, and in good general health, may donate blood. Donors must bring a photo ID, know the last 4 digits of their Social Security number, and their birth date. Anyone who donates will receive a free Peace, Love, and Donate t-shirt.
If you are unable to make a donation on campus, the Bloodmobile will be back in March. Or you can make an appointment online at www.donatingforlife.org. Courtney Willie, Lakefront News.
Thank you, Courtney. This week is Halloween week, and students are anxious to partake in Halloween festivities. We go to our reporter Sarai Bejarano for more on the story.
Even though Halloween is next Wednesday, students have already begun their Halloween festivities.
This past Thursday, the annual event Lakeween and Boo Bash kicked off the Halloween activities by inviting students, alumni, faculty, staff, and several hundred children and their parents from around the community to do some trick-or-treating on our campus. The activities began with Lakeween, which was sponsored by the Education Club at 5 p.m. The event took place at the Library Circle, where visitors could participate in games, a costume contest, and obtain free food. However, the fun didn't end there. At 6 p.m., visitors began to go through the decorated halls in the Eastside Residence Halls that include Centennial, Flores, Pachali, and Ayers, where they stopped at several rooms where residents passed out candies to the children.
I think last night at the Boo Bash, everything was well organized, people were having fun, and we had a very, very good turnout.
Yet some students who didn't attend these events are looking forward to doing some other annual Halloween rituals.
Annually for Halloween, we pumpkin carve, so I look forward to that. And we usually invite over the family to make cookies, because my mom makes sugar cookies in different shapes, and we bring the kids over and they decorate them.
I think I just look forward to the candy, because I do go trick-or-treating every year like a loser, because I love it. Honestly, I love dressing up and I love getting free candy.
If you go out trick-or-treating with family and friends, make sure to be precautious and stay in well-lit areas. This has been Sarai Bejarano reporting for Lakefront News.
With Election Day rapidly approaching, reporter Jesus Cortez went to talk to students about early voting and find out what SGA will be doing to help students to get out to vote.
With Election Day right around the corner and early voting in full swing, I want to speak to students about the importance of voting and whether or not they're going to participate.
I do plan to vote early voting depending on my schedule, if my schedule allows it.
I chose the early voting route just because I don't want to have to stand in line with other people and I can do it at my leisure.
I also spoke with student Ramiro Ramirez on why he thinks voting is so important.
I think it's important for young students like myself to get my voice out there.
President of SGA, Stephen D. Zumanan, explains how vital this election is to students.
With depending who is elected could really affect I guess, loans, student loan debt as well, and future aid for students in general. So this is something I feel that all students should be concerned about, you know, not just myself, but I mean, it's an effect every single student, regardless of your what walk of life you came into or what your situation may be, it's still going to affect them.
Stephen also informed me on how SGA will be helping students go out and vote on Election Day.
We're going to have a shuttle, a university van, going on the hour on Election Day, November 6th, taking students to and from the voting location site.
The last day for early voting is November 2nd. For more information on early voting, you can go to elections.bear.org. Jesus Cortez, Lakefront News.
Thank you, Jesus. October is National Breast Cancer Awareness Month. The Volunteer Unity Council at OLU hosted Pink Week dedicated to inform students about the most common diagnosed cancer in women. Neda Escamilla gives us more on the story.
1 in 8 women will be diagnosed with breast cancer in their lifetime, and more than 40,000 will die, according to the National Breast Cancer Foundation.
I want to encourage our OLU community to be aware and engaged, because a lot of things are relevant to either ourselves or the women in our lives, and sometimes even the men in our lives. And since breast cancer is the second most leading cause of death in cancers among women, it's important.
During Pink Week, the Volunteer Unity Council gave students free pink treats, such as cupcakes and popcorn, while educating them about breast cancer.
Any kind of awareness will help students know that they need to get checked and they need to be a little bit more conscious about their body and learn the steps that they need to take to be safe.
One surprising fact people may not know is that breast cancer can also be diagnosed in men.
You shouldn't be embarrassed, because it's better to have that 15 to hour of embarrassment versus potential death or years of suffering due to not getting checked, due to not taking those preventative measures or just a simple doctor's appointment.
I would say every 3 months, mammogram. Every 3 months, and not just that's breast cancer, but also cancer. You want to get blood work done.
To find out how you can join the fight against breast cancer, you can visit the Susan G. Komen For the Cure website at www.komen.org. Help end the second leading cause of death amongst women. Neda Escamilla, Lakefront News.
Thank you, Neda. In other news, are you looking for extra tutoring for your classes but can't find the Student Success Center? Our reporter Roxana Rubio brings us more information on their new location.
If you need extra tutoring in your math, history, or writing classes, you no longer have to walk across campus. The Student Success Center is now located in the basement of Moy.
Decided this would be an ideal spot to put all the student success together. So student success is student academic support. It's tutoring for history, Spanish, psychology, science, math.
Senior Patricia Sanchez is a regular at the Success Center.
It's more roomier. We have more room to, we have computers now. Everything was all against one wall. And there was tables all bunched together, and there's more room for us to walk around.
The Student Success Center offers many ways to help your studies. Take advantage of them and stop by to set up an appointment today. Roxana Rubio, Lakefront News.
Before we leave, we want to remind you, like we did at the top of our newscast, that early voting ends on November 2nd, and Election Day is November 6th. If you are registered to vote and want to find out where you can cast your ballot, contact the Student Government Association for more information. This concludes our newscast for this week. We invite you to visit us online at lakefrontsa.com/TV for more stories. I'm David Romo signing off. We will see you next week.